From Studio One at Broadcast Place, live local breaking news continues.
More Commitment 2012 coverage for you now. When it comes to politics, the Beacon and Tommy's Ham House are Southern staples.
We're not just talking about the food. Over the years, both have become must-stop places on the campaign trail for some very well-known names at that. News 4's Angela Rodriguez tonight on how these family favorites have evolved into political powerhouses.
Make it heavy on that bit.
Beacon is a, was started in 1946, and it has been, kind of a landmark in Spartanburg for many years.
For most upstate families, it's a rite of passage. Doctors, lawyers, and everyday people come here for the same thing.
Having a chili cheese delight extra governor.
And seasoned politicians know where there's good food, there's always a good crowd.
You don't have to campaign at the Beacon. You have to campaign at the Beacon if you want to win.
One of South Carolina's most famous politicians, Strom Thurmond, started the long-standing tradition of holding court here.
Strom Thurmond would come in. He loved to get a strawberry milkshake, and he liked our pecan pies, too.
It's even attracted presidents. But John McCain holds the record for the largest crowd at the Beacon. More than 1,000 people turned out to hear him speak after he won the New Hampshire primary. He went on to win the nomination, and since then, every big-name contender has made an appearance. And in Greenville, there's Tommy's Ham House. George W. Bush made this place a hub for politics when he was seeking office.
We always kid everybody, the only way to the White House is through the Ham House.
Governors, senators, and every presidential contender since then have all followed suit, making this meet and three a political hotspot. Owner Tommy Stevenson doesn't play favorites.
We welcome anybody, the Republicans or Democrats.
He serves up a little slice of Americana 7 days a week and proudly displays the Declaration of Independence, the bread and butter of the American way. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF, News 4.
Bread, butter, and jam.
Yeah, quite literally. By the way, Newt Gingrich plans to speak at the Beacon tomorrow.
And Tommy expects even more visitors as the primary draws near.